I'm going to show you how to automate the filter cutoff for Massive in Samplitude Pro X. I have a single bass note programmed plus a drum part. Make sure the Massive track is selected, and I'm going to the track editor where it says effect and left clicking, and go to the bottom where it says Massive, and I'm choosing parameter 34, which is filter 1 cutoff. Now we have a white dotted line. I'm going to the effect list again here, but this time I'm choosing edit selected curve create, and we have a curve generator. So you have a choice of whole notes, half notes, quarter notes or eighth notes. I'm just going to go through them. I have triangle selected as the shape, so I'll click OK. At the moment it's not doing anything, because if I go to the list again, you can see that inactive is ticked, so make sure that is unticked. I'll play it again. I'm going to change that now to the half note. I have a keyboard shortcut to open the curve generator menu, half. Quarter. Eighth. So that's the curve generated for the entire part, which is not necessarily what you want. So I'm just going to remove that. So I'll go to edit selected curve, delete. This time I'm going to draw in a range just between bars 2 and 3. Just expand that a bit. And I'm going to the curve generator again. I have it assigned to Alt plus E, which opens it up. I'm going to stick with eighth and triangle, but this time I'm going to tick create curve points in range only. Click OK. So now we have it in the range only. I'm just going to move the last node back down so it closes the filter at the end. In fact, I can delete that node. And I'll play that from the beginning. So that's slightly behind the beat, and I'm selecting the first node. So it turns black, and then I'm shift selecting the last node, and all nodes in between are selected. I'm just going to drag it to the right. See what happens now. And you can just drag them down if you want to have the filter slightly less open. And you can just adjust individual ones. If you want to move a node without it moving from left to right, hold down the shift modifier as you do it, and it will make sure it stays in the same place. I'm going to move a few of those up. Move that one down a bit. Let's try that. So that's basically how you do it. It all works from the effect menu here. You've got the edit selected curve create, and you can also invert it if you want to. See what happens there. To change it back, just click invert again and it will restore it to what it was. So if you wanted to put, say, another curve generated selection in another part, just select that and go to the same list again, create, but say maybe make it fourths this time. Click OK, and now we have fourths. I'm just going to drag down the last one again. So go from the top. Again, that's slightly out of time, so you can just select the first one and shift select the last one and move it along. I open up Massive, you can see the filter is moving, this one here. So that's how you do it, and I suggest you experiment with the various parameters, but all in all, it is possible to do this type of automated filter cutoff within Samplitude and create a dubstep type wobble bass effect.